SEP fees. However, it's ordinary and troubling something looks. If it is covered by an SEP field, no one notices. SEP stands for somebody else's problem. And it's a highly perceptive social comment in our book. Often, responding to a real problem requires both vision and courage. Vision to see what might be done, what needs to be done, and courage to pursue and fulfill it. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, to whom we must all give account, guide with your spirit the members of this Borough Council. May they be guided by your wisdom, and may they seek in all their purposes both to have both vision and the courage to fulfill it. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Please be seated.
That the monitoring officer, in consultation with myself, has granted permission for the meeting to be filmed and photographed. If anyone present, including members of the public, object to being filmed, will they please indicate that? Could I remind everyone who has a mobile phone that it should be switched off or turned silent whilst the meeting is in progress? Before I begin, I would particularly like to welcome new elected councillors to the meeting. And the new councillors are Ilan Valakin, Councillor Gage, Councillor Hockley, Councillor Peter Wolf, Councillor Maguire, Councillor Phillips, Councillor Riley, Councillor Whittle. Can you all stand, please? Agenda item 1, election of mayor. Councillor Gardner, move.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Could I say first of all that I consider it to be an honour and privilege to propose Councillor William Quinton for mayor for the coming year. I do notice that Bill, of course, is known as such, and rather than William, to his friends and as men. And it's interesting to know that even the official document this evening calls for the mayor to be Bill Quinton. So, Mr. Mayor, I think that just about says all we need to know that he has a great number of friends already in the town because of his great involvement in various aspects of the town and its life. I did find it rather interesting that we both seem to have followed a rather similar path to arriving here this evening, with Councillor Quinton being nominated as mayor, albeit for the second time. We both failed our 11 plus. We both attended Tyrone Park's secondary model store, which they subsequently pulled down. And we went into apprenticeships with Ipswich owned and based engineering companies. And there aren't many people who can do that today. Bill was first elected to the council in 1984, the year that I was actually honoured to be mayor of the borough. And I welcomed him to his first council meeting in this very room. It's fair to say that much of what we see in the Ravenswood area of Ipswich is down to the involvement of Bill Quinton. His development has been very close to his heart and has played an important role in its development to what we see today and continue to do so. Planning is where he has shown us, I think, that he has real pride in our town. And he's led the Planning and Development Committee in a firm but fair way for many years. I'm sure that he will do the same sitting in that chair over there for the rest of the municipal year. He has, of course, a part on the forecourt of the means that you won't have quite as far to come with his tin of brass soap to be able to polish it now, as he has been for a number of years. He was quite concerned when it got moved once, but it was tracked down. So no doubt that any improvements made to the Tangle forecourt, he'll be there keeping a watchful eye as to where that back finishes up. He is, of course, a man of many talents, and he is a bowls player of some standing in the county. I've even got a penny pump on me which says, Suffolk Bowl, Phil Quinton, President, 2011. And I know that there are a number of my colleagues who also got a similar pen. But I think it's good to know that he has this interest, and I do understand that it's possible that there may be some selectors in the room this evening, so if he plays the cards right, he may well get selected for the Tangier game. But there's one phrase which sums up to members of either group, and also to those of the planning committee, and at the end of every meeting, Councillor Bill Quinton says, he wishes us all a safe journey home. Bill, we wish you and Barbara and your families a safe journey in your year ahead as Mayor. Mr. Mayor, I therefore make the formal proposal that Councillor Bill Quinton be elected Mayor of the Borough for the period of the annual meeting of the Council in 2015. Thank you.
Councillor Mills.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Like many others, I have known Bill Quinton for quite a few years. Indeed, once I worked for him when he worked for the co-op. But for the past 7 years, it has been a great pleasure to work with him as a fellow councillor for Priory Heath Ward. And this morning, as usual, I got my early morning call, early for me at 1 o'clock in the morning, by which time Bill had read all his emails, knew what to tell me, knew what to ask me to do, and I'm hoping for some relief in the coming year. Bill is a very thorough councillor. Councillor Gardner has already referred to his work in the ward, but I can add a few other points. We quite regularly meet at the Salvation Army, where everybody knows Bill, and it's fairly slow working your way around the ward for the number of people who want to have a word not with this Bill, but with that Bill. And we're very grateful to the Salvation Army for giving us refreshment when we get there. Bill's experience in the ward dates back, as Councillor Gardner has inferred, but not actually said, for many more years than the 30 years he has served as a councillor, because he worked for a long time at Alston's, and perhaps that explains why so many people know him. He is, as has been said, very proud of the Ravenswood development, and he bore the brunt of that in the early days when it was very contentious, and he ensured with officers that that is a community. A community which has a good, rich balance of people and some wonderful facilities, all built on the council's old site. A very successful development, an example to many other parts of the country. That's just an example of how a local councillor like Bill can work with officers, work with the community to weld together all the necessary elements. Another aspect of his work has been with the police through the South East Neighbourhood Partnership Group for many years, in again bringing together all of the elements that are needed to ensure that the safe community is safe and secure. Bill comes to the mayoralty again, not just as one, but as a party. I mean the family party. Barbara, who does so much work for good causes and puts on wonderful spreads for us and is such a wonderful host, and his two sons, Howard and Gallion, and the rest of the Bowles team, or at least a substantial part of it. It's a question of debate which one is the best bowler. So I'm looking forward to the poll for the coming year, very much looking forward to the coming year. I'm sure Bill is looking forward to the coming year as well, and the whole of special style of leading our community. Therefore, Mr. Mayor, I have pleasure in seconding the motion that Councillor Gardner has moved.
Are there any other nominations? In that case, I declare Councillor Quinton elected. fulfil the duties of it according to the best of my judgment and ability. I undertake to observe the code as to the conduct which is expected of councillors from Ipswich Borough Council. I am proud to announce that my mayoress for the year is my wife, Barbara. We are both looking forward immensely to the year ahead, to representing the people of Ipswich and promoting our town. I would like to invite Mrs. Quinton and Mrs. Weeks to step forward for the town sergeants to pass the chain of office for Mrs. Weeks and Mrs. Quinton.
And not a little flair. He's been extremely ably supported by Daisy Weeks as his mayoress, who's been an excellent mayoress. Elegant, with an engaging smile and a warmth of personality which has delighted all those who've met her. May I, through you, Mr. Mayor, say how much we, in a vicarious way, have enjoyed Hamil Clarke's 13 months as mayor, and we wish him and Daisy Weeks every blessing as they almost sit down from the two posts that they've held. I have great pleasure in moving the motion that the best thanks and appreciation of the council be accorded to Councillor Clarke for the manner in which he has discharged his duties and upheld the dignity of the office of Mayor of the Borough during the past year. I move the motion.
Councillor Knowles, second.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have great pleasure in seconding the motion which Councillor Byrne has moved and have not much to add save for this. Last night, the Mayor had a little get-together with the people who had given him support during the year. And what a wide selection of people they were, because Hamil's networking is quite incomparable. I found myself sitting opposite an old acquaintance. I didn't know that he was not only a solicitor, but a portrait painter. And somewhere I understand there was a portrait of our mayor, our ex-mayor now, and I think that's probably the first portrait of the mayor that's been painted for a good many years. I'm looking forward to seeing it. That's a tribute to Hamil's diversity and the way that he has so many contacts with so many people in the town and so much respect from the community. It's a great pleasure to second the vote of thanks to him and to Daisy.
Thank you. Is the motion carried? Thank you. Councillor Clarke will remind his vote of thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Daisy and I have been honoured to represent the town over the past year. And I must say at the offset, I'm sorry, Mr. Mayor, that I have encroached on your term of office by a few weeks through no fault of my own. Daisy and I have had the most enjoyable year because I hope that in doing so, we have served the people of Ipswich well. Everywhere we went, everyone has been very welcoming. And there are two questions that were always asked of us. One is, is there any difference compared to 16 years ago? And secondly, is it difficult being a mayor? The answer to the first question I always gave was, yes, there's a difference. There are different communities, different organizations, and different people. But I see Ipswich as one family. And the second question, the answer to the second question was, we didn't mind being there and there's difficult at all. We both like meeting people and talking to them. And as a lot of you would know, Daisy can talk for anyone. So that worked out well. There have been many highlights, and it's difficult to choose one ahead of so many. But as my theme for the year was primarily about young people, it was a privilege to visit our three charities on more than one occasion, as well as a number of primary schools. And I must mention the Barbados Day Enchanted Park, the Mary's Soul Night, which was most enjoyable on both occasions, and especially my visit to Arras. In Arras, I joined the Deputy Mayor to unveil some plaques at the cemetery that would enable visitors to use their apps and access information on any of the soldiers mentioned. But highlights I would mention on this stuff. Daisy and I have been on an educational journey. We have learned much about Ipswich, the different communities that make up Ipswich family. I must give a special thanks to Daisy, however, for being my mayoress and all the support she has given me. I could not have done the job without her. Finally, I must thank Councillor Fern and Councillor Knowles, not only for proposing and seconding me a year ago, but also for their support throughout the year. I must also give a special thanks to the mayor's team, who have kept us on the straight and narrow and made everything run smoothly. And they are Christine, Andrew, and Andy. And Mr. Mayor, I wish you and Barbara a very enjoyable year. It's enjoyable as Daisy and I have. Thank you. Agenda item number 2, appointment of Deputy Mayor. I move that Councillor Hamil, Clarke be appointed Deputy Mayor for the period to the annual meeting in 2015. All those in favour? Thank you. That is carried. Can I now ask Councillor Clarke to step forward for his roving chair? We now move to agenda item number 3. Do we have any apologies for absence?
I have received apologies from Councillors Clarke, Councillors Gibbs and Councillor Brown. Are there any others? Thank you. We now move to agenda item number 4, the minutes of the council meeting held on the 19th of March 2014. Can I thank Simon as a true record? Thank you. We now move to agenda item number 5, executive appointments. Councillor Ellesmere, can you report any changes that you have made in respect to the deputy leader and executive for the period to the annual meeting of the council in 2015? Councillor Ellesmere.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor, and congratulations on your election. I can confirm that Councillor Neil McDonald will remain Deputy Leader of the Council. However, I wish to announce two changes to the Executive. Councillor Adam Leader, unfortunately, has had to step down from the Executive as a result of commitments following a change of job. I'd like to put on record the thanks of the Council to Councillor Leader. I am sorry to see him step down. He's made a very positive contribution to the Executive. And I think this is a reminder to all of us that working age councillors constantly have to juggle the demands of work and council, and that it's not always possible to reconcile service at portfolio quality level and a full-time job. I am pleased that Council Leader will be able to continue as an excellent board councillor for Alexandra. I'm also very pleased to announce that Council Leader's place in the Executive will be taken by Councillor Sophie Mydeck, who I'm confident will prove a valuable addition to the team. Mr. Mayor, I'm also proposing that there will be an additional place on the Executive. When Labour took control of the Council in 2011, we stated our commitment to a more open and accountable administration. To demonstrate this, we offered the Chair an overview and scrutiny to an opposition councillor, contrary to the practice of the previous administration. We've maintained that offer every year, despite the increased majorities, and we will do so again this year. We also made an offer to the leader of the Conservative group and a non-portfolio office seat on the Executive. It is our belief that challenge makes for better decisions. Equally, for important decisions facing Ipswich, it can be useful to demonstrate that there is cross-party support for a course of action. So I'm pleased to report that, for the first time since 2011, the Conservative group have agreed to take up this place. Mr. Mayor, I'm proposing no further changes to the composition of the Executive, and in line with previous years, a detailed list of the areas covered by each portfolio holder will be circulated in due course.
Thank you. Thank you, Councillor Ellesmere. Council notes the changes to your appointments, which will now move to the next agenda item. The next item is item 6, and it's the allocation of committee places. I would like to remind councillors that the report has been circulated and is included in your papers that have been circulated this evening. I then move to Councillor Ellesmere to present the report. Councillor Ellesmere.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. This is the same standard report that we get every year, which sets out the membership of and proportions of committees, working groups, service groups, outside bodies, etc. I don't propose to go through it one by line with last year. But I would just like to draw attention to Council's attention to the last page of the report, which is more unusual this year, which is the programme, the vice programme meetings. I draw Council's attention to the dates of the planning committee, which have changed from previously circulated dates as we move to a four weekly cycle of planning committee meetings.
Thank you. Councillor McDonald to second.
I can't second.
Thank you. Are there any other councillors who wish to comment? Thank you. All those in favour, please shout. Thank you. Thank you. There's nobody against? No abstentions. Thank you. We then move to the last item on the agenda. That concludes the business, and I declare the meeting closed. Can I ask councillors and guests to remain in the grand hall until you are invited upstairs to the council chamber for my reception? For those of you who are not staying for the reception, may I ask you to stay fairly home. Thank you.